Welcome to all. I am Lakshmi, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, Sri Adi Chinchanagiri Women's College at Kambam. Now we see about OSI reference model. This OSI reference model has developed by ISO. The expansion of ISO is International Organization of Standardization. This is called the model for open system interconnection. It is commonly known as a OSI model. The ISO-OSI model is a seven-layer architecture. It defines seven layers or levels in a complete communication systems. These seven layers are physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, finally application layer. First, we see about feature of OSI model. The communication over network is understandable through this OSI model, and also how hardware and software work together. We can understand new technologies as they are developed. Troubleshooting is easier by separate networks. And also it can be used to compare basic functional relationships on different networks. Then we see about what are all functions of different layers. First, the first layer is a physical layer. This physical layer is the lowest layer of the OSI model. It activate, maintain and deactivate the physical connection. And it's also responsible for transmission and reception of the unstructured raw data over network. Voltages and data rates needed for transmission is defined in the physical layer. The physical layer convert the digital or analog bits into electrical signal or optical signals. Data encoding is also done in this layer. Then we see about data link layer, the second layer. The data link layer synchronizes the information which is to be transmitted over the physical layer. The main function of this layer is to make sure data transfer is error-free from one node to another node over the physical layer. Transmitting and receiving data frames sequentially is managed by this layer. This layer establishes a logical layer between two nodes and also manages the frame traffic control over the network. And also the data link layer signals the transmitting node to stop when the frame buffers are full. Third layer is a network layer. It routes the signal through different channels from one node to another node. It acts as a network controller and also manages the subnet traffic. It decides by which route data should take. It divides the outgoing messages into packets and assembles the incoming packets into messages for higher levels. The fourth layer is a transport layer. The transport layer decides if data transmission should be on parallel path or single path. The functions of a transport layer are such as multiplexing, segmenting or splitting on the data are done by this layer. It receives messages from the session layer. It converts the messages into smaller units and passes it onto the network layer. The transport layer can be very complex, depends upon the network requirement. Then fifth layer. The fifth layer is a session layer. The session layer manages and synchronizes the conversation between two different applications. Transfer of data from source to destination session layer streams of data are marked and are resynchronized properly so that the end of messages are not cut prematurely and data loss is avoided. Then sixth layer. The sixth layer is the presentation layer. The presentation layer take care that the data is sent in such a way that the receiver will understand the information and will be able to use the data. While receiving the data, presentation layer transforms the data to be ready for the application layer. It performs data compression, data encryption, data conversion, etc. seventh layer, that is the application layer. This application layer is the topmost layer in OSI reference model. A transferring of files disturbing the results to the user is also done in this layer. Mail services, directory services, network resources, etc. These services are provided by the application layer. This layer mainly holds application programs to act upon the received and to be sent data. Then we see about merits of OSI reference model. The OSI model distinguishes well between the services, interfaces and the protocols. Protocols of OSI model are very well hidden. Protocols can be replaced by new protocols as technology changes. This OSI reference model supports correction-oriented services as well as connectionless services. Demerits of OSI reference model. The model was devised before the invention of protocols. Fitting of protocols is a tedious task. Finally, it's just used as a reference model. Thank you.